मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव रीड अबाउट द यूनिफिकेशन ऑफ जर्मनी। इन दिस चैप्टर राइज ऑफ नेशनल इन यूरोप वी हैव रीड ऑल दोज काइंड ऑफ सर्कमस्टेंसेस व्हिच हैव राइज द फीलिंग ऑफ नेशनलिज्म। टुडे वी विल रीड अबाउट द यूनिफिकेशन ऑफ इटली ब्रिटेन and what was the problem of Balkan. This is a very important part of this chapter where we read about the nationalism and imperialism. First, you have seen last videos issued by me about this chapter. There are 4 or 5 videos. This chapter is very important to think about the nationalism. We know the 30% courses are reduced from your syllabus. In history, first 2 chapters, nationalism in India and nationalism in Europe, is too much important for your board examination. You will read carefully and prepare the notes according this video or this topics. You know, we have read about the unification of Germany and France. How the France has developed the feeling of nationalism and how this spread of nationalism all over the Europe. We have read about the 1830 to 1848 of revolution. After then, we have seen that many states went to the independence. When we guys talk about the Italy unification, we know after the rise of the liberalism, they have supported to the nation state. In that time, Italy was also several dynastic states. That time civil war, Italy was divided in 7 parts. There many different dynasties are ruling there, but only one state, Piedmont, was an Italian state where the Italian ruler are ruling the country, and overall the other ruler was different from the Italy. In that time, you know about the Giuseppe Mazzini. He was a revolutionist. He was a favor of unification. He was inspired by the French revolutions and ideologies. He also wanted to unification of Italy. In that time, Italian language had many variations. There, the north was under the Austrian Habsburg, and the center route was delivered by the Pope or Spanish. There are many differences to control the Italy, and also we have explained about there are the 7 states. Piedmont was only the Italian state, and other was the different from order to rule by the Spanish and Armenian Austrian Habsburg, and by central administration was ruled by the Pope. The Giuseppe Mazzini always want to put together the program for the unification of Italy and Italian Republic state or countries. He joined the secret societies Carnivore. He also exiled from his country, but he has made a secret society called the Young Italy. From this society, they have spread the revolutionary ideas all over the Italian peoples in favor of the liberalism. Result was that they have involved and they have spread, they have collected the groups of the liberal Persians, and army also supported them. Also, they have the Victor Emmanuel. They have started the fight against the ruling parties. Result was that in that war they are defeated. After the defeat of the revolutionaries, the ruler of the Sardinia, Piedmont ruler Victor William, have come forward to the unification of Italy. With the help of armies, with the help of the revolutionaries, they have started the war against the ruler parties who have divided into different states. And there, the chief minister also, the chief minister of Cornwall is also in a favor of the unification of Italy. With the help of Spain, with the help of France, they have fought against Austria and defeated them in 1859. After the defeat of 1859, and then in a leadership of the Cornwall and the Victor Emmanuel Wesley also had proclaimed southward, the march southward, and defeated Spain. This movement have defeated the Austrians and Spain. After one, they have defeated the war. Liberals and the Italians, revolutionaries, had proclaimed the king of the Italian Victor Emmanuel of United Italy in 1861. In 1861, also in 1861, Italy made a United Italy. It is called the United Italy, and different countries are one part of the Italy, combined the part of Italy. तो ये जो यूनिफिकेशन के प्रोसेस जो इटली को करने की शुरू हुई थी वो लिबरलिज्म के थॉट्स और आइडियाज से डेवलप हुई थी, जिसकी शुरुआत जो यूरोप में डेवलप हुई थी उसके आगे लिबरल को सपोर्ट करने जोसी मेजनी का नाम आता है, जोसी मेजनी जो यूनिफिकेशन के लिए उसने लड़ाई लड़ी, ही हैड मेड द इवन सीक्रेट सोसाइटीज यंग इटली, ही वाज इंस्पायर्ड बाय द फीलिंग ऑफ द ideology of the France and the empowered by or the emphasis by the liberalism ideologies. So he had made the secret society and fought against the monarch. In that time, वहाँ पे सात तरह से इटली बटा हुआ था, अलग एक तरफ तो ऑस्ट्रिया के ऑस्ट्रिया था, सेंट्रल में जो पोप का था और स्पेन का रूल चलता था, तो ये डिफरेंट रूल्स चलते थे वहाँ पर। इनके अगेंस्ट यूनिफिकेशन की बात की गई, लिबरलिज्म ने उनके अगेंस्ट फाइट की, लेकिन वो परास्त हो गए, हार गए। इसके बाद जब ये हार गए तो इसकी जो यूनिफिकेशन की जो जिम्मेदारी थी, जो सर्बिया और ये सर्बिया और पेडमोंट का जो रूलर, जो कि ओनली वन इटालियन रूलर था, उसने उनके रिवॉर्ड को फॉरवर्ड करने का जिम्मा लिया, अपने ऊपर लिया, उसने उसको आगे बढ़ाया। उसके जो एक मंत्री कांग्रेस का आल्सो द फेवर ऑफ मोस्ट जो फेवर ऑफ दिस मोमेंट, तो ही टेक द हेल्प ऑफ स्पेन और फ्रांस, उसने फ्रांस की आर्मी की मदद ली, इसके आर्मीज की मदद के साथ लिबरल के साथ जो लिबरल को सपोर्ट करते थे उस आर्मीज के साथ, फ्रांस की आर्मीज के साथ एमोशन और कॉन्वेरी ने इनके आगे लड़ाइयाँ लड़ी, एंड आफ्टर द 1859 दे हैव डिफीटेड द ऑस्ट्रिया, आफ्टर देन दे मार द साउथवर्ड एंड डिफीटेड टू द स्पेन। ऑस्ट्रिया और स्पेन को हराने के बाद वह जो एक उन्होंने विक्टर एमोल को एक निर्वाचित यूनाइटेड इटली का राजा बना दिया, और इस तरह इटली का यूनिफिकेशन होता है, इटली का एकीकरण होता है। क्लियर? तो यहाँ पे ये दिख रहा है कि जो नेशनल की फीलिंग्स थी किस तरह एक साथ जो भागों में, जो अलग अलग शासन में डिवाइडेड इटली एक भाग बन गए, और 1861 से इटली यूनाइटेड इटली के, या एक सिंगल इटली के नाम, नेशनल स्टेट इन सिंगल नेशनल के नाम से, यानी इटली नेशन के रूप में जाना जाने लगा। नाउ टॉक अबाउट द स्टैंडर्ड केसेस ऑफ ब्रिटेन। ठीक, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द स्ट्रेंज केस ऑफ ब्रिटेन, व्हाट हैपेंड इन ब्रिटेन, we know very well in that time the liberalism feelings are spread all over the Europe. Britain was also inspired of In that time, the industrialization has begun. The UAE or United Britain industrialization has too much advanced in advanced condition. The Britons made, in that time, a new class had developed is called the ethnic class, which has the much power in a social, economical, and political power. They have meant their group, their ideology was same, their the group of culture was same. They have decided to the emphasis of this ideology, and they have seized the power. They have marched the this ethnic class in march on the palace and Athena Monarch in 1688. They have seized the power of monarch and control all power in the ethnic class. What all power is covered by the controlled by the ethnic class. And after them, Ireland was supported them. Ireland is also wanted the unification of Britain. And that time, the Act of the Union 1706 United Kingdom is called the United UK of and in United Kingdom of Great Britain, here the Scotland, for Scotland and England became united. So, yahan par jo ki Scotland ke log bhi the jo liberalism ko support karte the, their ideology was same. When the ethnic class had became forward, they have supported them. After the siege of the power of monarchs, they have maintained their government and they have agreed to the unite. After then, 1877 made the United Kingdom of the United Kingdom of Great Britain. Ireland was also separate from this part. Britain was also wanted to the combine of Ireland. There are the two groups, where the Catholic and Protestant. They have different ideology with each other. They fight against each other. They fight each other with the superiority. So they want to establish their ideology, they want to establish their roots in over the Ireland. But the Britain has support to the Protestant. Britain has proposed and they have stressed the Catholics. In that time, Britain ne unke daman kiya, unko control kiya. Britain has imposed their language, they have imposed their ideology, they have protest to the Catholic Protestant and dominate to the Catholics. So in that time, jo unhone dominate kiya Catholic ko, Protestant ko favor kiya, and circumstances at least the Protestant has dominate to the Catholics. After that, Ireland became a part of the United Kingdom. In that time, after the United Kingdom, and in a present time, United Kingdom is called the Great Britain. Great Britain is a part of UK. UK is a part of Ireland, Scotland, and England. Clear? In present time, when we talk about the UK, there are the three countries are combined each other: Scotland, Ireland, and England. Okay, now clear. So we have also discussed about the history of Britain. Now we talk about the liberalization of Britain. What when Britain became, they had adopted the one language. They had adopted the one national flag. They have made a national flag for the countries. They have maintained the national anthem for the countries, and they have maintained the one language for the nation. So one nation and anthem, flag and language, this kind of unification has become to identify the nation. This type of the visualizing of nation has spread all over the world, and every nation wants to establish their identity through their the language, through their the flag, through their the anthem, or through their the unification of the states. Now we talked about the liberalism of the nation. In that time, Every country has proposed the identities as a nation. How they can present their the which figure of the nation? No, anybody know what is the figure of nation? Artist and idealizer present the ideology of the nation. In France, we have read about the Patrick Chéreau. They have presented the female who has taken an alignment of alignment in left hand and in right hand. They have taken the Charter Act. They present there's the figure of the. This is the symbol of liberty. Okay, and this is the figure in that time. Which figure present to the nation is called Allegory. What is the allegory? Allegory means the who represent a person, presented country as a person. किसी भी कंट्री को एज ए पर्सन प्रेजेंट इसका अलग किया जाता है उसे एलोग्री कहते हैं. क्लियर? तो यहाँ पे एलोग्री का मतलब हो गया जैसे फ्रेंच है रिप्रेजेंट फ्रेंच है रिप्रेजेंट एलोग्री एज द मैरिनो को उन्होंने एज ए प्रेजेंट किया नेशन डे. ही वाज सिंबल ऑफ द लिबर्टी. ही वाज अ सिंबल ऑफ द जस्टिस. ही वाज अ सिंबल ऑफ द रिपब्लिक. And also French has present the many identities for the unification or the symbolic unification of their the freedoms or their the feelings like as a symbol as a breaking chain, red cap and so on. In as same Germany has represent a nation as a female figures, Germania. Armenia, he was the symbol of the liberty, of the 50, symbol of the justice and republic. So both states have present their nation as a allegory, and means the this or the presentation of as a person. The marine, you know, see in the paragraph, he wear the crown of. ओक यानी ओक के पत्तियों के क्राउन पहने में रहती है. तो ये जो फिगर बनाया गया ये शो कर रहा था कि नेशन को किस प्रेजेंट है. यू नो इंडिया एज ऑल्सो रिप्रेजेंट द भारत माता. भारत माता यानी ही प्रेजेंट इन नेशन एज अ फीमेल फिगर ऑफ भारत माता. तो दिस विजुअलाइजेशन रिप्रेजेंट द नेशन फिगर्स are the symbolic figures of liberty, justice and republic. Now we talk about the nationalism and imperialism. What is the nationalism and imperialism? Nationalism, you know very well, nationalism is Rashtravad. कि Rashtravad क्या है? जो nation की feelings करे, nation को present करे, ये identity अपनी हो, अपनी एक पहचान बने, this is called a nation. And imperialism means साम्राज्यवाद, कि हम अपनी boundary को कैसे फैलाएं, हमारा देश कितना बड़ा हो जाए, क्षेत्र कितना बड़ा हो जाए. तो दिस इज द टू फिगर ऑफ नेशनलिज्म एंड इंपीरियलिज्म. तो नेशनलिज्म, आई हैव टू मच एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द नेशनलिज्म. मैंने बहुत ज़्यादा एक्सप्लेन कर दिया है नेशनलिज्म के. वी टॉक अबाउट द इंपीरियलिज्म. व्हाट इज द इंपीरियलिज्म, हाउ वी कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ बाल्कन इज इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. बाल्कन इज एरिया ऑफ रोमानिया, बुल्गारिया, आर्मेनिया, ग्रीस, क्रोएशिया, बोस्निया, सर्बिया, स्लोवेनिया, मॉन्टेनेग्रो एक्सेट्रा. दिस ऑल इस एरिया इज कॉल्ड द बाल्कन एरिया. यहाँ पे क्या था, दे हैव डिफरेंट लैंग्वेज, दे हैव डिफरेंट स्टेट, दे वॉन्ट टू एक्सपेंड दे आर द बाउंड्रीज विथ ईच अदर, दे फाइट विथ ईच अदर टू द overseed of their kingdom. They want to establish their the kingdom with each other, they fight each other, establish their ideology, establish their the circumstances to reach their for the spreading of their nations. So this strategy is the policy. तो ये सारी चीजें वहाँ जो कि एरियाज में जो पेयर पॉपुलेशन लिव इज कॉल्ड स्लाव्स. इनको क्या कहा जाता था, स्लाव्स के नाम से देखा. तो ये सारी कंट्रीज में थी इंडियन ऑटोमन एम्पायर्स पे. ऑटोमन एम्पायर्स का वहाँ पे राज था. वह यूनाइट नहीं था. दे आर डिवाइडेड बिटवीन द डिफरेंट आइडियोलॉजी. सो दे आर नॉट एग्जिबिट ईच अदर. तो व्हाट वाज रिजल्ट क्या था, दे फाइट विथ ईच अदर end of this area was a greedy area for the other countries like Russia, Germany, Britain, and Russia and other countries. They wanted to, they had the monopoly in this area. So they wanted to monopoly, they have exceeded their boundaries in this area. They fight with each other. Rejected was they wanted to superiority to present in there. So fight them, will fight them against. They have supported the different countries by Russia, Germany, America, present in this field. So result was that जो ये सारी कंट्रीज थी जो इस एरिया में अपने अपने को डेवलप करना चाहती थी, अपने सुप्रियॉरिटी शो करती थी, यहाँ क्योंकि यहाँ डिफरेंट लैंग्वेज के लोग थे, डिफरेंट सपोर्टर थे, कोई रशिया को सपोर्टर करता, कोई जर्मनी को, कोई स्पेन को सपोर्टर करता, या डिफरेंट सपोर्टर, तो इन कंट्रीज को लोगों ने अपने अपने ढंग से सपोर्ट किया, तो ये सब कंट्रियाँ क्या है वो आपस में लड़ने लगी. तो इस तरह एक काफ़ी जो टेंशन की जो कंडीशन हुई, तो इस कंडीशन ने एक बहुत बड़े जो प्रॉब्लम को डेवलप किया. रिजल्ट वॉज दैट द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर बिगेन इन 1914. क्लियर? तो दिस इज क्लियर कि व्हाट इज द बाल्कन एरिया. बाल्कन एरिया इंपॉर्टेंट फिगर इज द एग्जांपल ऑफ इंपेरियलिज्म विद द रिजल्टेड द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर हैज फॉर्ड इन 1914. क्लियर? तो आई हैव also explain this chapter, the rise of nationalism in Europe. Okay, this chapter is over. Next video I will start the next chapter. Thank, have a nice day.